This program is brought to you by the following sponsors.
What is going on, guys? Jay Shy here with another video, and today's video is another manga quick chat. I just got through reading Tsutomu Nihei's new series, which is Aposimz. It was really annoying me how much I felt like I was mispronouncing the title of this book, because at first I was calling it Aposimz, because I thought it was pronounced Aposimz, but it's Aposimz. So I've noticed a bunch of people are actually have their own way of pronouncing this manga. But anyway, regardless of that, I just got through reading the very first volume, and I figure it was garnered, you know, the attention of doing a manga quick chat on it, just in case you guys have seen this and then you're wondering whether you should, you know, dive into it. And I'm gonna try and do this manga quick chat quickly as possible without giving you guys any spoilers, because I notice a lot of people that do videos on any mangas, it's cracked filled with a ton of spoilers. So this is a sci-fi, I would say, action kind of thriller. It has a nice sci-fi thing happening for it as soon as you open the book. One of the things that I will tell you guys, if you're a fan of Tsutomu Nihei, is that one of the things that's going to bug you about it is the artwork. First and foremost, the artwork, it doesn't compare to Blame at all, or Blom, if that's the way it's pronounced. But I know a lot of people are comparing it to Blom, not Knights of Sidonia, what's the other one? Biomega. A lot of people are comparing it to his past work, and one of the things I've noticed about his artwork in doing this story is that the artwork is very, very loose. It almost looks like he's working on this by himself. It doesn't look like he has any assistants helping him out with, like, the backgrounds or anything. But it just comes off very loose. But anyway, in terms of the story so far, it's very sci-fi gritty. It has, like, this weird kind of technological, like, aspect running to it. So, the characters are living on a world called Aposimz, and it's inhabited by, I guess, it almost seems like they're humans, but they're also ravaged by something called frames, which is kind of like your sci-fi take on the modern day zombie, I guess. But if I had to tell you guys what this story is like, is it almost comes off like a blend of Biomega meets Guyver, if I had to compare these two. Because when I was reading it, I was almost like, wow, I'm getting a lot of, like, futuristic kind of Biomega Guyver feels from this story. Because one of the things which I don't want to spoil, but it's hard to not talk about it, because it seems like it's one of the core intricates of the story, is it looks like there's two different kinds of frames in the story. One frame, it just kind of seems to slog itself around, and it kind of comes off like a zombie. And then you have other frames that have abilities, but they also have awareness to the world around them, which is fantastic. One of the things that, at first when I was reading this, I wasn't really reeled in. I wasn't reeled into the story because Nihei is writing the story really fast. It almost seems fast-paced. I was like 4 pages in and I was already hitting into the action. Like, I was already there and I was like, whoa, this is moving pretty fast, but it was good nonetheless. Then it kind of slows down and then it picks back up again. The pacing is almost like riding a wave, which is very interesting for this kind of story. Then there is like a long kind of section which I was really sucked into, with the main character meets another character called Titania, and Titania is teaching him how to use these newfound abilities, let's just say that. And because I don't want to ruin it, I want to give you guys the chance to go ahead and check this out. But that section of the book was really, really interesting. So far, I am into the story. I'm really wanting to see where this goes. I only have on hand. I haven't read that one yet, only because I'm reading other things as I'm like kind of rotating through my books. But I do recommend this. I recommend this book quite a bit, actually. It's got some strange pacing going on, and the world seems very loose, because I know a lot of people tend to see things with I would say they tend to look at a lot of detail, so they like a lot of detail. This book doesn't, it has detail, but it's very loose, like I said before. So don't let the artwork turn you off. Read the book. The book is pretty good. If you can read it online, read it online. If you're anything like the sustain the industry types, go ahead and buy the book. I definitely recommend it. It seems like it's going to be a pretty interesting story down the road. One of the things, though, is that the book tends to throw a lot of techno mumbo jumbo at you that it almost seems like you're supposed to know, but you don't know. And almost it feels like the book doesn't explain that. But hopefully we will learn it together, like in terms of us being the readers and, you know, Nihei being the author. Hopefully he kind of like goes in depth and explains what all of these things are. But anyway, nonetheless, I do recommend this book. And if you enjoyed this episode of Manga Quick Chat, please leave some comments down below and let me know what you guys think. And I will see you guys next time. Peace.